Hello and welcome to the devlog number 3 of Planetary Life, a simulation game about planet, life and evolution. Today we are going to talk about the new UI system. Recently I did some changes, so now you can see that we have a main menu here in the top left, where you have the tools, the different views, the planet configuration and stats screen. And if you go to the tools, you can see that now every tool have small descriptions with some nice animations that also is telling you what is the price of each of the tools. Let's make it a volcano here, so it's going to, you can see that it's showing you how much was the cost, and here the price is going down. Here on the bottom right, the different buttons to stop the action. Also, you can just play as normal speed, accelerate speed by 5, or accelerate the speed by 10. Another thing we have here is the new views menu, where you can see different type of views. You can see the normal view, tectonic plates, altitude, temperature of the planet, moisture, rainfall, and wind currents. Also, we have the planet configuration menu, where you can have geosphere and atmosphere. In the geosphere, you can modify the core heat. But if you increase the volcano activity, you can get extra energy per second. On the other hand, you will see that if we accelerate this, now the planet is going to start little by little getting filled with random volcanoes everywhere. This is not going to be good for our planet. Also, in the planet configuration, we have atmosphere, where you can see the cloud albedo and surface albedo. You can modify this. The more you go to the streams, the more energy you are going to get. Same with the surface albedo. Streams is going to give you more energy, but also is going to make harder conditions in the planet. And finally, we have the rainfall area and rainfall rate, which is going to modify how the clouds are acting in our planet. On the other hand, we have the stats menu. You can see the how the temperature has been changed across the years, but okay, this is a build in progress, so you won't see much apart of this small graph here. Now, when you are going to select a tile, you click in the tile and you will see this small box here telling you information about the selected tile. If it has any kind of plants, you can click here, the other tab, and you can see the information about the plants. This is work in progress. Also, if you select a creature, you will see information about the tile, but also you will have this new tab here for the lifeform or the creature. When you click there, you will see a small preview of the creature, and also you have different information about its health, what is the kind of food that it needs, attack, defense, and other things. Now the camera movement is free, so you can leave that tile selected and move around to different places to check what's going on. And if you press this button, you will focus the camera to the place. Another thing that has been added is like now you can right click and drag and drop to move the camera through the world. This was requested by some people, so finally has been added. Mainly that's everything from this devlog. I hope everyone liked it. I think it makes the navigation through the game is much easier than before. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Remember to subscribe and like the video so you can keep updated about following updates of the game. Thank you so much and see you next time. Bye bye.